I started in 2009 when I was made redundant from a school where I worked as the IT technician. The school was attended by young people who live with cerebral palsy, and I was approached by parents of those children for help and advice on what equipment might help them in their home, and I recognised that people were short on information and opportunities to actually get their hands on the equipment. So I bought pieces of equipment like the equipment you see here and took it out to people's homes and set it up and gave them opportunities to use it for things that were motivating, fun and interesting for them to do.
What do you and your business do to improve the lives of people who live with disabilities?
I bring information to people. A lot of the equipment that I work with you cannot find on the shop shelves, and so there is little information and opportunity for them to get their hands on it, so to speak. So I bring it to them and help them identify ways that the equipment can make a difference to their lives, but also help them identify ways that them, with their special individual needs, might be able to interact with the computer.
What was life like for the people that you've worked with before they were introduced to Sensation?
I've come across quite a few young people, families, adults, who have bought equipment like the equipment you see here, something like this, or this, which is equipment that allows interaction with technology and computers. And they might have bought it because they thought they needed it, and in some cases they did need it, but then that equipment would sit gathering dust for some time before I came and actually put it to use. And that could cause a little anxiety amongst individuals and families, because they'd spent what can be a lot of money on equipment and felt they weren't getting the most out of it.
So how has the life of these people changed since they were introduced to Sensation?
Changes can be small for some people, but for others they can be considerably larger. For example, a gentleman I work with, for who following a road traffic accident sat for 3 years unable to interact with people around, to communicate with people around or interact with his environment, for example, operate his television or turn on a light. And after 25 minutes of my first meeting him, this chap was able to spell words on the computer screen using his eyes with a system called iGaze, and also operate his TV from an iGaze computer, which he found to be life-changing for himself.
So what is an iGaze computer? Would we be able to have a look at one?
Yes, there's one in front of you here. It consists of a tablet computer and a special camera attached to the bottom. The camera monitors the position of a person's eyes and will place the cursor on the screen relative to where the person's looking. And the camera, put simply, is an alternative type of mouse. Those who don't need iGaze might use a mouse with their hands, but those who need the special access can now do it with a special camera.
Could we have a demonstration?
Of course. And this is what's called calibrated to my eyes, and using the menu system down the side, I can select using my eyes a mouse operation, for example, double click, and then open a program, which I'll do now by first selecting double click and then opening the Kindle program. So first I select double click, and then I look at Kindle. That's selected the open menu, so I'll left click now on the word open. There I have Treasure Island opened up in Kindle.
Yeah.
It's not filling the screen, so I'll use the left click button maximise the screen, and I've achieved all that without using my hands. I've opened Kindle, and now I can sit back and enjoy reading the book independently without any assistance from anybody else. That's one of the main benefits of iGaze, independent control.
How important is the ability to use this kind of technology for the people you work with?
It's important in that it brings independence to the person, and opportunities to explore new ways of doing things that perhaps they were able to do before but lost those skills or have never been able to do either, ever.
So finally, why is the assistance that people get from Sensation different from, say, a specialist school or hospital?
I visit people in their homes in most locations around the country, and I'm available at relatively short notice. In other agencies might take weeks to be able to get into people's homes, and also this equipment belongs to my company and it's all in the boot of my car, and I can have it in the home and set up within half an hour.